So nice to see familiar faces. So, I'm here to provide you an introduction to PASC and an overview of the workshop. Perhaps some of you will be hearing about PASC and for the first time. So I guess it's good also to introduce the network and what it is all about. All right, so maybe just to provide a background, the network was established in 1996 through the Administrative Order number 303. And what's so special about 1996, it's the first time that the Philippines hosted the APEC. So that's why the Philippine APEC Study Center was established. In response to the APEC Leaders Education Initiatives that called on member economies to foster regional cooperation among higher education and research institutes on key regional economic challenges. So, PASCN has provided opportunities for collaborative research among its member institutions and serves as a forum to discuss important regional integration issues as these impact the Philippine economy. So apart from that, the APEC is also a member of the Asia-Pacific Economic Cooperation Study Centers in APEC member economies and is part of the APEC Study Center Consortium. I think one of the most recent activities here in the Philippines was the hosting of the APEC Study Center Consortium Conference in 2015 as one of the APEC 2015 SOM 2 meetings, and it was held in Bogotá. But who are the members of this network? So we have currently 12 member institutions. So let me just read them. And I think some of them are here participating in this workshop. So we have Asian Institute of Management, Ateneo de Manila University, Central Luzon State University in Nueva Ecija, De La Salle University, Foreign Service Institute, Mindanao State University, PIDS, which is also the lead convener, Siliman University, University of Asia and the Pacific, University of the Philippines, University of San Carlos, and Xavier University. So, the objectives of the network is to promote research, establish and maintain data and information base, encouraging faculty and students to undertake studies and theses and dissertation on APEC issues, facilitate information exchange, and so on. But so all these objectives are translated into four programs that the network is, that the Secretariat is currently handling. So we have four. The first one is the research programs. Then we also have a thesis and dissertation assistance program, information and dissemination and publication, and then the technical assistance program. So let me just go through each very quickly. So the research program is generally based on the APEC agenda and its related issues on regional integration, globalization, as these impact the Philippine economy. So often the Secretariat would send out calls for proposals to PASC and network members, asking them to submit research proposals on key APEC issues. And recently we've had completed studies on MSMEs, and which are also available in the PIDS website and PASCN website. We also have the thesis and dissertation assistance program, which aims to extend financial assistance to graduate students of PASCN member institutions in the writing and production of their thesis or dissertation on APEC related issues. So again, it's supposed to be related to APEC issues, and we try to support the completion of thesis and the dissertation of PASCN network member students from PASCN network member institutions. Unfortunately, it's limited to PASCN network member institutions. So, in case you know anyone who is studying or trying to conduct research in APEC-related issues, please let them know that there's possible funding from PASCN, if they're part of that network. All right, and so let me just, the information dissemination publication, we try to conduct an annual symposium, and recently we had one, and it's sponsored by UP in UPBGC. And the symposium, technical workshops, and roundtable discussions are undertaken to disseminate the results of studies and also to solicit comments. The recent annual symposium that we had in UP, which is dovetailing to the annual public policy conference topic on Industry 4.0 and the fourth industrial revolution, was an opportunity to present key findings on the studies conducted by network members, and was also a forum to discuss important economic issues. We also usually have regional presentations. We try to echo what we do here in Manila to the regions. And finally, what we're doing today, technical assistance. So we try to provide technical assistance to the government, and as a member of the technical board on APEC Matters, we try to also provide some technical assistance to members of the DIBANG. Okay, so now let me talk about what we're going to do today. Today we're conducting a research funding and collaboration workshop, which aims to do the three things. The first one is to facilitate the exchange of information, and then to undertake capacity building, especially for those who are member of DIBANG agencies, and to provide technical assistance to, of course, some government agencies on APEC-related issues, which would be for session two. So we have three sessions, as I mentioned. Session one is a funding opportunity workshop, funding opportunities in EU workshop, Horizons 2020. Session two is APEC projects applying for funding. And then session three is about the APEC policy tools project, which PIDS is also handling. So this is actually really for the DIBANG agencies, so they have an idea what we are doing here at the PIDS. So that would be all, and I hope you have an understanding of what PAS